My dear students, I hope you all are well. So let's start from question number 15 onwards, from miscellaneous exercise, chapter number 5 of class 12th. See what is given. Question number 15. If x minus a square plus y minus b whole square equal to c square for some c greater than 0, prove that this value 1 plus dy upon dx raised to power 2 whole power 3 over 2 over d square y over dx square is a constant independent of a and b. Means when you solve and you get this value equal to something, that should not have a and b both. So let's start without wasting time because this is a lengthy procedure. So I'm going to start from this given. We have this only. So now this is given. X minus a square plus y minus b whole square equal to c square. One thing is quite clear, you have to write dy over dx and d square y over dx square. So let's write their derivatives, differentiating with respect to x. First of all, what about derivative of this? 2 will come in front of this and its power will decrease by 1, means only x minus a will left. Then derivative of x minus a. Derivative of x is 1 minus derivative of a is 0. Now here, the same procedure, 2 will come in front of this, y minus b with power 1. And what about the derivative of y? Dy over dx. And of b, 0. And c is a number only, derivative is 0 here also. See, in all these, 2 common. And what is left inside? X minus a plus y minus b into dy over dx equal to 0. In next step, you can leave this and you will get only answer for this value. So x minus a plus y minus b dy over dx equal to 0 over 2, or we can say it is 0. So give it number 1. This equation is very, very important equation, so you have to remember it. This equation will help us to continue further. So I am going to mark this separately because in that there will be a need of this equation. So we have x minus a plus y minus b dy upon dx equal to 0. This is our first equation which I marked separately. Now I am going to erase the statement here, okay? And what is the requirement that I will mark? And this statement also separately. This is our given equation, x minus a. You can give number to this equation, okay, as 1. Mark it as 2. It will be more clear then. So, 2. Equation 1 is given equation. X minus a whole square plus y minus b whole square equal to c square. This is 1. And your requirement. What is your requirement? You want that its answer should be independent of a and b. So I will write also here, okay, its value dy over dx raised to power 2 whole power 3 over 2 over d square y over dx square, which I want to prove is independent of x. So I'm going to erase this. We don't have any use of this now. I marked all the required things. This is having only single derivative. Let's write its derivative once more. Again, differentiating with respect to x. This is question number 15, okay? Okay, this is first value, derivative of x minus a, 1 minus 0. Then there are two parts here, 1 and 2. If you want to write derivative, there will be use of product rule. So first, as it is, derivative of second means d square y over dx square. Then plus dy over dx as it is, derivative of the first means y's derivative dy over dx minus derivative of b is 0, and there is no effect on the right side, derivative of 0 is 0. See what is left here, it will have 1 plus y minus b d square y over dx square, and here you have, see, dy over dx 2 times. So it will be dy over dx raised to power 2. Students, take care of this. It is not d square y over dx square. It is whole square of this value because it is 2 times and equal to 0. Now, First of all, see the requirement of question. You have dy over dx with 1 and having square also. Dy over dx whole square. This value and 1, they are together. So we will write in this way. See, I will write these two values in the right side. Y minus b in the left side as it is, along with d square y over dx square. And these two I will shift in the other side. 1 will go as minus 1 and this value will go with negative sign. So dy over dx whole square. Next, take minus out, or common we can say from this, 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2 equal to this. Or if I shift this y minus v, it will go in the denominator of this. So we have answer for our double derivative. This is our third equation. From this third, from equation number 3, okay, see, you have value of d square y upon dx square. Do you have its value anywhere in this calculation? No. We have to mark one more calculation here, okay, see. No, not of this kind. We will do one more change here. We will mark y minus b, because y minus b is there in previous calculation. We will shift this value to the right side. So minus common. So you have to remember this, students, there may be some mistake. You have to check your requirement of question. Accordingly, you can continue. So you have to shift this value to the right side. Don't mark wrong. Change, okay, that will create a problem. What I checked any value like that, d square y over dx square, or is there or not? It was not there, but you have this y minus b. See, y minus b is in this equation in which you have first derivative. So I will put from 3, put value into equation number 2. So I will replace in equation number 2 this value dy over dx along with y minus b. So y minus b's value I have, I will replace there. See what will happen here. So x minus a from 1, from 2, sorry. So x minus a plus y minus b dy over dx equal to 0. This was equation number 2. Now replace y minus b. What is y minus b from 3? So x minus a plus y minus b's value is, so I will replace here, okay, plus, once write in the proper way, minus of 1 plus d square y, dy over dx whole square over, yes, over d square y over dx square along with dy over dx. It is equal to 0, or in other words, we can say it is, this is equal to, here we can say it is x minus a plus, plus minus minus, you have this, minus 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2 upon d square y over dx square into dy over dx equal to 0. Further, if I write value of x minus a, x minus a will be, shift this value to the right side, it will go as it is, 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2 inside, I'm writing in this way, okay, so over d square y over dx square into dy over dx. This whole will go to the right side with a positive sign. So we have answer of our x minus a also. I will give it number, we marked up to 3, so give it number 4. So we have two values. One value was in equation number 3 and one is in equation number 4. Now we will go back. In equation number 3, value was of y minus b, which I marked here. And equation number 4, we have value of x minus a. We will put these values in this equation number 1. Now put values from equation number 3 and 4 into equation number 1. So we will put values from equation number 3, 4 into 1. So in 3 you have y minus b's value, in 4 you have value of x minus a. So first is x minus a square. So it will be like a square of this value. So it will be square of this 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2 over d square y over dx square dy over dx raised to power 2 according to the statement given. And what about y minus b? Y minus b's value marked here. It was minus of this value 1 plus dy over dx square over d square y over dx square raised to its square equal to 0 equal to c square as given in the statement. So it is value of y minus b. I marked from here this value of y minus b. So its square equal to c square. Now we have only calculation work, and after calculation you will get an answer independent of a and b. So what is here, separately write their powers. So what is with you? You have here, I am writing square separately. So I am going to write square of this value first. So it is 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2 whole square over denominator d square y over dx square raised to power 2 along with dy over dx, this value its square also. Same in this side, minus square plus, and you will have 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2 whole square over d square y over dx square raised to power 2 equal to c square. So we have calculation like this. See what will be next after this. First of all, see you have this value with you, but its power is 2. So we have to write it once. I am going to mark it as LCM and I will shift there in the right side, and we will see what is here with us. So we have 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2 whole square. I am going to take LCM, and LCM is this whole value because it is same. So d square y over dx square raised to power 2 is there LCM. Simply you have to add numerators. So dy over dx square, this is first numerator, now plus second one. Second is 1 plus dy over dx square raised to power 2 equal to c square, or it will be, this will go to the right side and get multiplied with c square. So it will be d square y over dx square raised to power 2. And this left side we have, it is 1 plus dy over dx whole square raised to power 2 d square y over dx square plus this value 1 plus dy over dx whole square raised to power 2. Now we have this only, but what was our requirement? We need some kind of calculation which will help us here, okay? So you have there, this was with I marked wrongly, it is whole square of this. So we have whole square of this. See these two, 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2, 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2 whole square also. We will take this value common. From the left side we will take it common. So I am writing it common, okay, dy over dx raised to power 2 whole square. It is common. If it is common, from first one what is left? This value dy over dx raised to power 2, and here total is common means plus 1. Equal to the right side will remain the same, d square y over dx square raised to power 2. So here you have this, see, they are exactly the same, 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2, 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2. This is same as this value. So we have 2 times here, 1 time here. So what will be the power? It will be cube of this value. So it will be 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2 whole cube. And in the right side you have this. This will be c square डी स्क्वायर वाई ओवर डी एक्स स्क्वायर रेज टू पावर टू. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल शिफ्ट दिस टू द लेफ्ट साइड, इट विल बी वन प्लस डी वाई ओवर डी एक्स स्क्वायर रेज टू पावर थ्री ओवर दिस डी स्क्वायर वाई ओवर डी एक्स स्क्वायर रेज टू पावर टू इक्वल टू सी स्क्वायर. This value we are shifting in the denominator on left side. So I am going to mark its next calculation and you are very near to the answer. See what will come after this. So when you solve it, you will see. First of all, shift square of c in the left side. Or we can say it will be the square root of left side. When will you write square? Okay, take care of this. In the left side, it will become square root. So square root of this value, 1 plus dy over dx raised to power 2. होल क्यूब ओवर डी स्क्वायर वाई ओवर डी एक्स स्क्वायर रेज टू पावर टू इक्वल टू दिस सी ओनली बिकॉज वी आर शिफ्टिंग स्क्वायर एज स्क्वायर रूट. सो स्क्वायर रूट इज ऑफ होल वैल्यू. दिस टोटल इज हैविंग स्क्वायर रूट. सो मार्क इट क्लियरली. ओके, इट इज स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ होल वैल्यू. व्हाट अबाउट स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ द न्यूमरेटर? वी कांट मार्क इट. वी कैन राइट इट एज 1 प्लस डी वाई ओवर डी एक्स स्क्वायर raised to power 3 and its square root separately over. Here you have square of d square y over dx square, so only one time it will left. D square y over dx square will left only one time. And right side is c, only value c. Now what? See, square root means half power. Already it has power 3. So its power 3 means this same value. Its power will be now 3 over 2 because square root means half power. So its power will be 3 over 2 over b square y over dx square. And what answer you have for this? Its answer C. It was your requirement. Same we have. And its answer is C. Do you have any value like A and B here? What do you want to prove? You want to prove its answer is independent of A and B, and clearly there is no number like A and B, so we can write which is independent of A and B, hence proved. So this was our long calculation which needs patience and clarity of steps. So pay some attention, try to solve them again and again, okay, to understand these things. They are not difficult, they are easy if they get proper attention, or if you pay some attention, or if you try to solve them one or more times. So see what is next, question number 16. Students, our question number 16 is, if cos y equal to x cos a plus y with cos a not equal to plus minus 1, this is only a condition, prove that dy over dx equal to this value cos square a plus y over sin a. So see how we have to start it, okay? Remember its procedure. Firstly, given. You are given with this only. So given is cos y equal to x cos a plus y. And here students, first of all, try to find answer of x. X will be shift cos a plus y to the left side. It will go in the denominator. And in the numerator, cos y will be there. But see, how will you find the derivative? You want dy over dx, but here you have x only. Right side whole calculation is in y. So here you have to remember one thing. Now we will differentiate with respect to y here. This is the question which you have to remember properly. An important one in which you will differentiate with respect to y, because you will get dx over dy then, and that will give up reciprocal or required answer. So differentiating with respect to y. Differentiate dx over dy. And right side quotient rule, it will be square of the denominator, square of this denominator. Then how we write derivative of numerator denominator as it is. So derivative of numerator means d over dx of cos y, d over dx, no, it will be d over dy, derivative of numerator into denominator cos a plus y as it is. Then minus sign, derivative of denominator, d over dy of denominator is cos a plus y into numerator as it is, which is cos y. So So carefully write answer. Okay. Where we are differentiating with respect to y. So what will be derivative of cos y minus sin y? Because derivative is with respect to y, so you don't have any need to write dx over dy. So because it is in y. Similarly, okay, here you have to repeat cos a plus y as it is minus. What about this derivative of cos a plus y? It will be minus of sin a plus y along with the derivative of this angle. So this will give plus sin a plus y along with the derivative. Derivative of a is 0 and derivative of y is 1 into cos y over square of the denominator, which is cos a plus y raised to power 2. See the next time will be raise it. We will continue after this here. Okay. So we have this step, which is dx over dy. What is in the numerator? Let me write once again this. It is minus sin y into cos a plus y plus sin a plus y into 1 will remain the same into cos y. So we have this kind of calculation, denominator raised to power 2, which is cos a plus y raised to power 2. Now rearrange these values of the numerator, means this negative value after the positive value. So I am writing sin a plus y into cos y first. This is the positive value minus negative sin y cos a plus y. Denominator will remain the same, cos a plus y raised to power 2. So we have this calculation. Now see, is it in proper order? We will rearrange this also. Isn't it like, see, sin a means a plus y, cos b, then minus, it should be cos a means cos a plus y, sin b means sin y over cos a plus y raised to power 2. What is that formula? Formula is sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. It is sin a minus b. So try to remember, students, this formula. What is a? This value will work as a and this value will work as b. So write formula. It will be sin a, which is a plus y, minus b means minus y over cos a plus y raised to power 2. Y cancelled. So you have sin a over cos a plus y raised to power 2. But this is not our requirement. Our requirement was its opposite, because we marked dx over dy here. Now we will write dy over dx. So its reciprocal will be our required answer. So mark taking reciprocal. So when you write reciprocal of this, that will be your required answer. So write taking reciprocal. Reciprocal will give dy over dx. Its opposite means cos a plus y raised to power 2 will go in the numerator over sin a. Now in our requirement we have power 2 of cos square, means it will be cos square a plus y over sin a, which is our required answer of this question number 16. So required answer, or hence proved. So this was our question number 16. See next one is given in question number 17 after this. Question number 17 is, if x equal to a cos t plus t sin t and y equal to a sin t minus t cos t, find d square y over dx square. But see, x is a function of t and y is also a function of t, but you need d square y over dx square. Let's start by writing it as, okay, first of all, x equal to a cos t plus t sin t in a bracket, okay. And what about y? Y is a sin t minus t cos t in a bracket. So we have this, first of all, differentiate with respect to t, because they both are functions of t. So we have to differentiate it with respect to t. So it will be dx over dt. What about derivative of the right side? A as it is, inside what is there? First term is cos t, its derivative is minus sin t. Plus, this value is product of two different functions, 1 and 2. Use product rule, first t as it is, derivative of sin t is cos t. Then plus, sin t as it is, derivative of t is 1. Then, after that, a as it is, minus sin t, plus t cos t, plus sin t. And sin t we can cancel, you are left with a t cos t. Now, similarly, you can differentiate y with respect to t. So, dy over dt equal to a as it is, derivative of sin t is cos t, minus. Here also you can use product rule. Minus sign is there, so take care of this. Put a small bracket before it. T as it is, derivative of cos t is minus sin t. Then plus sign, derivative of cos t we mark. Then cos t as it is, derivative of t is 1. Now solve it further. A cos t, open it, minus minus plus t sin t. Then minus plus minus cos t. And you can cancel cos t here. And you are left with a t sin t. So we have these two answers with us. Now we will write here dy over dx, which can be written as dy over dt over dx over dt. You marked earlier this kind of calculation so many times. So fill their values. What is dy over dt? A t sin t over denominator dx over dt. Its value is here 2 times t. I marked something wrongly. It is a, not t. So it is a. So write a t cos t. So a t they are cancelled. You have only sin t over cos t, which is tan t. But you need double derivative. You don't want single derivative. So write again, differentiating with respect to x now. You have dy over dx, now find the double derivative. It will be d square y over dx square, which is equal to, what about derivative of tan t? It will be secant square t. But it is in t, so it should be along with dt over dx, because we are differentiating with respect to x here. But what is dt over dx, which can be written as secant square t as it is? 1 over dx over dt. Shift this dt in the denominator of dx. But you have its answer with you. See, it is here. Put there its value. So it will be, see how we will replace in that double derivative its value. So its solution is okay. D square y over dx square equal to secant square t into 1 over this value a t cos t. So we have this. See what will be next. Secant square t into this cos a t cos t. This cos t will go in the numerator, and what will left? It is secant t in the numerator over a t, or it will be secant square secant cube t over a t. So this will be our required answer of question number 17. I think there is no difficulty to remember. It is very easy. I confirmed its answer. Its answer is secant square secant cube t over a t. See what is given next in question number 18 after this. Students, our next question number 18 is very easy. If fx equal to modulus of x raised to power 3, show that double derivative at x exists for all real x and find it. So you have to prove derivative exists, as well as you have to find derivative is having this value, means you have to write derivative's value. See how given is, what is given to us? This is fx, which is cube of x mod. Let's break it in two parts. You know this power 3. It will give positive answers only for positive values of x or 0 for 0. And negative answer when you have values negative. X, if x negative, you will get answer negative. If x positive or 0, you will get answers positive or 0. So we have to write it in two parts. So therefore, fx can be written as, divide this as sigma function in two parts. This value, it will be plus right first positive value x cube if x is greater than equal to 0 and minus x cube if x is negative means less than 0. Now write the derivative. Therefore, what about first derivative? What will be derivative of x cube? It will be 3x square, and this condition will remain the same for all the values which are 0 or greater than 0. And what about derivative of this? Negative 3x square if we have x negative. Now what about double derivative? One more time, write derivative. Derivative number 2, 6x. And here condition will remain same. It is only for x 0 or greater than 0. Here minus x, minus 6x if x is negative. So clearly double derivative exists, as well as we have its value. Double derivative exists, that's why you have its value. So we will write therefore f double dash x exists for all. You can find answer by using any value of x here, you will get answer, okay? For all x, we can mark here as an answer. So double derivative exists and its value is in front of you. This was question number 18. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you are understanding all the concepts explained. Try to subscribe the channel as soon as possible to get latest notification. Press the bell icon and see you later. Bye bye.